fingering and ones where she was not doing the right fingering.
Okay.
Except for one, because she's insistent that she likes the way it feels on her fingers, and so she really doesn't want to change
that. Okay, which one is that? You do not want to bother these silly fingerings. You want to do the one which is the most straightforward, because there's enough other stuff to worry about. And by already starting to find the most clever fingering, it's not the easiest fingering, think of it as it's the most clever fingering. It's an intelligent fingering. This one is a little bit of a silly one. So if you want to challenge yourself by practicing and making that really, really smooth, by all means do so, but do practice this one as well. And when it comes to performance time, you can choose the one you want to use. Yeah? Okay, fine. Let's play, what did we say? A minor, did we say? Yeah, A minor. We said melodic, remember? Or did you want to do melodic? You can also do harmonic if you like, or natural.
I can't remember which one
it was. I know, it's always hard to remember. Okay, I'll tell you the trick. Melodic, that's how I used to remember it when I was a child. Melodic, it's like a melody. And a melody is one long tune. Yeah, so the scale goes up one way and comes down a different way. So it's one long melody. The harmonic one is the one which is sort of Egyptian, you know. Yeah, that's sort of the Middle Eastern sounds. And the natural one is the really boring one. Alright, I never played that one. I find it so incredibly unattractive. My favorite one is always the melodic one, because it's more challenging. You like a challenge? Let's do two in a bow.
Thank you.
more challenging, isn't it? At the moment, you use quite a lot for the first note, and then not so much for the second note. So try to keep it more even. When you look at my bow, Do a small one.
Because
then you can concentrate more on a really nice pick rather than the bomb.